to my first video. And can we just start off by saying this is kind of low-key awkward, just a little bit. My cousin's been telling me to do this for a while now, and I felt like, you know what, why not? Everyone's doing it, so why not just try out and see what happens? I love watching YouTube. I love get to know me tags and husband tags, and like, I'm a very nosy person, so I thought this would be a perfect first video to make to basically get to know me, who I am. I feel like this is a great, like, I like it when people do this, so you kind of feel like, you kind of see if you even like are feeling the person you're watching, if you want to subscribe. So I'm not gonna ramble on just because I'm a rambler, and I know I hate long intros. So I think I'm just gonna get straight to the point of this video and get to know me a little bit. I like Googled get to know me tag questions, and I just made up my own little mix of things, like I like to know about other people or other YouTubers or whatever. Not like the whole favorite subject in school. Like, I don't care what anybody's favorite subject in school, and I'm pretty sure you don't care either. So I just put like a list of questions out. My laptop is over here, so I'm gonna be looking over here to answer the questions. 31 questions. I feel like they're gonna go fairly quickly, just because, you know, I don't know, I feel like it's just like really quick answers. really quick answers. I might ramble on. I'm gonna try my best not to ramble on. I'm really gonna try, but no promises. So let me just get, see, I'm already rambling. Let me just get to the point. I'm already like 2 minutes in and I'm already rambling. So let me see. The first question is, what's your name? I don't know if you can know, if you could tell or you noticed, but it's Christina. Very, very basic name. I love my name now. I used to hate it when I was younger. People used to call me Chrissy, and my cousins call me Tina. To this day, they call me Tina. But it's Christina. Took a while for me. I like, it's very basic, very, I knew like 9 Christinas in my grade. So, first question, my name is Christina. Are you named after anyone? Not that I know of. I was supposed to be named Bridget. That's what my mother told me. I'm so glad she didn't do that. There's nothing wrong with the name Bridget. It's just, do I look like a Bridget? I don't look like a Bridget. I think it's an Irish name, if I'm not mistaken. Question number 3, where are you from? I am actually from Jersey. I was born in South Jersey, Cape May Courthouse, New Jersey. But I lived in Wildwood. I lived a lot of places. I lived in Jersey City. I lived in Patterson, I believe. Cherry Hill, I remember. I lived in Pennsylvania. I lived in Connecticut. I went to like, I think 9 different schools. I counted like years back, but if I try to do it now, I probably won't be able to count them. But I think about 9 schools I went to. So yeah, it was tough. I was raised by a single mom with 2 kids. What's your zodiac sign? I'm a Pisces. Water sign. We're sensitive. We take a lot of things to the heart. We might overreact at times. It's tough to have a Pisces as a friend. You guys have to like be careful what you say and how you talk to us, because we're emotional. And don't tell us we're emotional, because then that will piss us off. We can be feisty too, don't get us wrong, but we don't like confrontation. We don't bring it to you, but we will bring it to you if we have to. But like, we're just so chill. I used to be very shy, and now I'm like really just like high strung. I don't know what happened. When's your birthday? February 23rd. I'm the end of February. I'm a winter baby. Where I live now, I'm good. But where I came from up north, my birthday sucked just because it was always snowing. It snowed always on my birthday for as long as I can remember. So being a winter baby up north sucked. But travel, cheap. So you can't take that away from us. How tall are you? I tell people I'm 5'3", just because I'm 5'3 and 3/4". I feel like 5'3 sounds cute, but I'm actually 5'3 and 3/4". So technically with shoes on, I'm 5'4". I think I need to start saying 5'4". Plus that's an inch taller than I say I am, and I can weigh more, you know, a couple extra pounds. but yeah, I'm just going to say it and stick to it now. Starting now, I'm 5'4". Okay, 5'4". What is your eye color? Doo-doo brown. I got brown eyes. Nothing special over here, honey. Like my mom used to say, someone used to say, I don't know who said, I have brown eyes come full of crap. Sounds about right. If I look over there, my window's over there, so people be walking by, and I know I look like a hot mess, but like talking to myself. But if you see me looking over there, you have two big windows right there. How many girlfriends / boyfriends have you had? Well, I haven't had a girlfriend, but I don't know. It depends. Like, as an adult, I feel like boyfriends, if you slept with them. As when I was younger, boyfriends is like, you kissed and went on dates. Like, it's, oh my God, it's so cute. So, I want to say, like, I'm going to go because I'm grown. Like, people I've slept with and that were actually my boyfriends. I only slept with people that are my boyfriends. Four. So, yeah, I know. I'm such a skeezer. Four people in my whole life. But there's a reason why I have such a low number. Just because you'll see the next couple questions. But, yeah, I feel like I've had four, like, boyfriends. And, like, maybe two or three little, we kissed in the hallway and stuff like that, boyfriends. Are you single, taken, or married? I am married. I've been married for March 21st. It was 4 years. So March 21st, 2015, we got married. But longest relationship, this one, we've been together for 12 years. So 12 long years. Like I can't believe we've been it this far. Like we've been through a lot. We've been through a lot. We got together fairly young, especially me. I was really young. So yeah, I've been with him since I was a teenager. Like late teens, 19, I think. I met him at 18. We got together at 19, and we've been together ever since. You know, besides a little weekend breakups, but you know, stupid young fights. Do you speak any language and how well? No, I don't speak any language. I wish I learned no Spanish. My mother, who's white, she speaks fluent Spanish, and I don't know nothing. Like, I understand it depending on the subject, but. That's like one of my goals, like my bucket list goals is to learn and speak fluent Spanish. Like that's like, you know, my ultimate goal in life. It's not nothing major, but it's like definitely something I think it's good to know. I love culture. I love other people's culture. So I think it'll be like a great, like thing to learn. Let's see. Next question. What's your race and nationality? So my mother's Irish and my father's Puerto Rican. So I'm an Irish Puerto Rican. I don't know. I'm always curious of what other people think I am when they first see me. I've gotten Portuguese. I got Brazilian once, but 'cause I was hanging out with Brazilian. So I'm wondering if that just, we both light skin, dark hair, long hair, dark eyes, I don't know. I've gotten Italian once, but a lot of people say I look Spanish, and then some people say I look like I'm a white girl. So I guess it all depends on the person, but I'm always curious to see what people think I am when I'm not nothing exotic. I wish I was, but yeah, I'm Irish and Puerto Rican from Jersey. When did you move out? I moved out when I was... Technically, I moved out when I was 15. I actually ran away. That's a great story time. I ran away 3 times in 3 years. Hot freaking much. Teenage problems, I swear to gosh. So yeah, I moved out at 15. And I got my own apartment at 17. That's when I moved from Connecticut to Jersey, back to Connecticut. And I got my own apartment. Mom, obviously, she had to sign the lease acting like we were moving in together. But I worked 2 jobs. I went to school. I paid my own bills. Like, so I got a check in the mail from when my father passed away when I was younger. So that helped with the rent and stuff. But I had to pay for my utilities. I had to pay for my food and house, even though my mom did help me with food. I didn't get paid. I didn't work a lot because I went to school full time. So, yes, 17. I had my moved out, ran away at 15. So technically, it's to say 17 because that's when I actually had my own apartment. So that was like a really good time in my life. And just because it was just like, I was able to be a kid and enjoy myself. So it was fun. I miss it sometimes. where did you grow up? See, that's like hard because like my other, But I said earlier, I moved a lot. So I didn't really grow up anywhere. First half of my life, I was in Jersey. And the second half of my life, I was Connecticut. Now I'm in a whole completely different state now. So I don't plan on moving at all. I'm done. So I kind of wanted to stay here. I like where I'm at. I love where I'm at, actually. It's kind of hot. And I want to put the AC on, but I don't want you to hear the big noise in the background. So I'm trying to be professional. I didn't really grow up anywhere. I really grew up all over the place, unfortunately. Where do you currently live? Oh, North Carolina. What a move. That's different, right? From the north to the south. I love the south. I absolutely love the south. I live in Raleigh. And I absolutely love it. It's not country at all. It's kind of city. But there's country aspect, a country like areas. Don't get it twisted. It can go country real quick if you drive 30 minutes a different way. It's like, holy crap, where am I? Please don't hiccups. I've been here since July of 2016. Yeah, so 3 years. What's the furthest you ever been from home? Another basic question. A basic answer. I've only been to Texas, and this was last summer. I went to Texas. So that was the furthest I've ever been home. Like, I traveled from like Massachusetts all the way down to Florida, up and down the East Coast multiple times. Never ventured off to the West, like going the West. And for the first time, cause my mom, my brother, my sister, they all live in Texas. Old Mexico and Texas, they go back and forth. I surprised them. That would have been a great vlog. I surprised them. Surprised my mom. My brother and sister came for the summer. And I love Texas. I love San Antonio. I can mess with Texas, but it's way too far from the beach. I'm complaining now when we're 2 hours from the beach. I can't imagine Texas, but I can mess with Texas for sure. I'm number 18, by the way. Number 18 is, do you have any kids? Yes. Good question. Thanks for asking. I do. We have a 10-year-old son. 10 years old. 10. And you think about it. We've been here for 12 years. He's 10. I got pregnant very early in a relationship. And I can't tell. You can't see. But I'm actually currently pregnant now. I am 30. I'll be 32 weeks on Tuesday. The whole 31 weeks, 4 or 5 days, I don't know. I'll be 32 weeks on Tuesday. I'm actually going to be doing a pregnancy vlog. Tag or Q&A or whatever about my pregnancy. It's a girl. My daughter. Can't believe I'm a girl. My daughter's crib area nursery is over here. So I'm going to definitely do a tour. We live in a two-bedroom apartment, and my lease was up when my due date was. So we're going to move next summer. So before she turns one, she'll have her own room. She'll be in the room with us, which is like different. We didn't do that with our son only the first couple months. So this is a big age gap. He's so excited, but I don't want to get into that question or that, because I want to make the video about that. And you know, it's interesting. It's definitely, I feel like a new mom, 100% feel like a new mom. What are your kids' names? Our son, name is Jay Sean. And then our daughter, her name is going to be Janiyah. I want to keep with the whole J theme. So Jay Sean, and her name is Janiyah. All right, no more. I don't even know why I need to answer these questions, because they're supposed to be for the pregnancy tag. Do you have any siblings? Yes, I am the oldest. I have my brother will be 30. He's in August, so he's 29. And then we had the same fathers. And then my mom remarried. Like I said before, my father died when I was really young. I think 3. I just turned 3, I want to say. I have a brother and sister, and they have different fathers. And my brother is 16. He'll be 17 in December. Oh my God, I feel so old. And then my sister, she's 15, and she'll be 16 in January. 15 and 16, and then me and my brother. Like, we're just a huge age gap, but I love them to death. I was only around my brother for a little bit when he was a baby, but I wasn't really raised with my sister. But we all have a really cool bond, and I can like talk crap to them. Like, they're like my ride or die, is 100%. Who was your first best friend? First, I remember a girl named Crystal, a girl named Barbara Walsh, and a girl named Christina Ortiz. Ortiz is my maiden name. So I remember those three girls. That's like the only memory. And I remember turning 10, being friends with them. So elementary school, like, you know, fourth grade, third or fourth grade. It's the earliest memory I can think of. And then the next, I had a best friend in Jersey and I had a best friend in Connecticut. I don't have any best friends now, unfortunately. I really don't have friends at all, actually. It's just, oh Lord, it's hard to be friends with girls. And it's just the way my personality is. I clash, and that's why I was always the home girl. It was just easier that way. But yeah, currently no best friends, but those are the best friends I can think of as my earliest time. Scary movies or happy endings. I love scary movies. Scary movies are my favorite. Every time I look for a movie, it's always going to be a scary movie. Always going to be a scary movie. Names, who are some of your favorite YouTubers? Ace Family, Gabby Hanna, James Charles, what the heck is that? The guy with the pig merch. I'm drawing a blank. I'm pregnant. Pregnant mind. I like Liv's Life. Liv's Life? She's a newer YouTuber. I actually kind of like her. She's like very relatable and don't care about anything or anybody and how they think or say about her. The Brand Fam, Nicole Guerrero. I love her so much. She don't post as often, but I love her. I know I'm missing people. I just can't think of anybody else. But yeah, I know I'm missing people, but the basics, I don't got, like, literally everyone knows. Favorite memory from childhood, I remember when I was living in Wildwood or went to Wildwood for summertime, my grandmother lived, like, down the street from the beach. I remember we used to walk to the beach, and that was, so I love the beach, So that's, like, my favorite childhood memory I can think of, was going to the beach with my grandmother, my abuela, from my father's side, obviously. What phone do you have? I have an iPhone. I'm a new iPhone user, and I have an old iPhone. I don't got no new. Like, I ain't no new over here, all right? Me and my husband got our first iPhones in August. And actually, so, quick story, we went to Texas, and I dropped it in the river, and only had the phone for a couple weeks, maybe a month. And then I lost it and had to get a new one. That's just like my life. I'm telling you, that's just like my life. One word that describes you. Like, I always say, like low-key corny, but in, like, a cool way. I'm corny. I know one word. I'm sensitive. I'm the most understanding person you will ever meet. Like, I'm extremely understanding. And I'm very forgiving. I know I'm good too many words, but, like, that I'm, like, that's just me. Like, that's my personality. But that's how I would describe myself. Introvert, extrovert. Definitely an extrovert. I have my tendencies where I don't, like, I'm introvert. But I think everyone has those moments where you just want to be by yourself. Definitely extrovert. 100% extrovert. I'm just very outgoing and friendly. I had this one. Are you left-handed, right-handed? I am right-handed, but my son's left-handed. You know. No big deal, but I think it's cool. Like, lefties, like, his cousin's lefty and my grandmother was lefty. So I think that's kind of cool. Like, you use your left hand. It's something small, but I think it's pretty cool. If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be? I always say California. I don't know why I always go to California. I've never been to California. Florida's too hot, and I never will go back up north. Like, I love Jersey, but I couldn't live there. I hate the winters. I absolutely hate the winters. Especially having a winter birthday. But I always say California. Because I've never been there. There's no rhyme or reason. It's California. What is your go-to fast food order? Basic answer. Like, if I go to Wendy's, it's like a chicken sandwich on the dollar menu and a small fry. Burger King. I don't like eating red meat. I'm trying to stay away from red meat, but this baby thinks things. I want other things. So it's a Whopper Jr. with cheese, no onions, and a small fry. I don't eat McDonald's. If my son catches me eating McDonald's, he'll talk hella crap. Let's see. And that's it. Taco Bell, maybe. I like the Crunchwrap Supreme Chicken or the Chicken Quesadilla. We have Bojangles. I don't eat that much. We ate it so much in the beginning that I'm over it. But basic girl. I'm a basic girl. I'm telling you. And do you have a PC or a Mac? I actually have a Mac. No, I just got it. I need it for my job. So for when I'm on maternity leave. So I just got a Mac and just, why not? I got the iPhone, my Mac. I'm trying to be like low-key bougie on a budget. Because this biatch is pre-owned. So I am not about that life. Not yet, though. Maybe one day. Maybe one day I can get some nunu. But right now, ain't no nunu over here. All right, see, that's a long video. That was a long first video. But yeah, so I have a lot of videos coming. I have a lot of ideas. Like I said, I'm going to maternity leave in like 2 months. I'm about to have a baby. I know after I give birth, I'm going to be on this weight loss journey because I'm already overweight. I'm actually like morbidly obese at this point, off the numbers on the scale and online. So I want to get snatched. What else? I have story times. I got like pregnancy tags. I got husband tag. My siblings are supposed to be coming this summer. Sibling tag. Like, I feel like at the beginning you do tags and get to know me's and this is my life. And then like down the line you do like an updated version. We want to buy a house. I want to buy a house next year. If not, we definitely have to move. We're going up to Connecticut in September. Like, I have a lot going on. So like, I don't know. I just think it would be fun to document. And if nobody watches me, at least I have like memories to watch and just laugh at myself. But yeah, so I really appreciate, if you made it this far, thank you. I really appreciate it. You know, this is gonna be funny saying, so press that like button, subscribe, click the bell for notifications. Like, just do me a favor. Like, just follow the girl, you know what I mean? You might like me, you might not. If you don't, hey, just keep subscribing and just ignore my videos. All right, guys, that's it. I've been rambling on too much. All right, bye.